Greetings, everyone. This is Andy, the cultural entrepreneur, and I'm out here at the Art and Soul Festival in Oakland, California. Currently, I am sitting in Joyce Gordon's gallery, who is in downtown Oakland, on 14th in between Broadway and Franklin. And as you can see, I'm sitting here right in front of the Black Panthers, All Power to the People. And as you know, Oakland, California was known for the Black Panther Party, as well as the revolutionary on uplifting the Black people and loving the Black people. I am branding myself as a cultural entrepreneur as I see how culture is needed among our people. Our culture has been stripped, starting from back in Africa. We had the infestation of the Anglo-Saxons, European history, however you want to look at it. From there, we were kidnapped, stolen, exchanged, sold to protect ourselves, and ended up during the Middle Passages where you have the oppression phase. And right now in Oakland, California, you may get a lot of history about, oh, Oakland is this, we're like in top 10 of the crime, and you are looking at a mentally possessed people. And so my goal, my vision in life is to holistically restore culture among our people. In the sense of creating that, reestablishing that culture, knowing that Black is beautiful, knowing that through us, a lot of the stuff that exists would not be here if it wasn't for us. You're sitting here, you're looking at artwork, how we inspire various people, how Oakland is holding an Art and Soul Festival. We are getting people from all over, not just the Bay Area, but even this weekend, we have an artist here who's from Denver, Colorado, John Toms, who has come to join us during this festival. And in a sense of being in the Bay Area, when I spoke to this artist, it was how Oakland is the beginning of music. Oakland is the beginning of culture. Oakland has been speaking to a lot of people. And I was born here in Oakland. I went away for a few years in the military, and I didn't expect to come back here, but something kept me here in Oakland. And I went through a transition period to where I experienced homelessness after the military. I began to see that although I served this country for 8 years, honorably served in all the wars, deployed 3 times, that when I touched down on this land, the color of my skin was the first thing that I was sitting here and looked upon. My dreadlocks that I had was something that was, oh no, you were not in the military. Yes, I fought the military on the last 6 years to maintain what was a piece of me, as I believe, as a Black woman. I grew up not knowing that African and being Black was the same thing. You could not call me African without me punching you in your face. That's how serious it was. I had no understanding of the greatness, of the beautifulness, of the culture, of the peace. And so I, as I mentioned, am branding myself as a culture entrepreneur to restore culture among our people. And by doing so, it can be in a way of art, preserving our culture, preserving our history. We have curators here, and it's not even just the love of art. Is more so the love of our people, of maintaining our history. My major is library science, and I have been, during that, I have been trying to understand, how did this disparity come about? But not only how did disparity come about, why are we accepting this disparity? Why are we allowing ourselves to stay economically disfranchised? Why are we sitting here killing each other? Why are we so quick to turn our nose up at a Black business? And so all these questions got me to the sense to where, okay, I understand it. How else do I get people to understand that? So I began branding myself. I began to understand who I was as an African woman. I began to know my history, to learn our story. And so I am sitting here giving thanks to those who have come before me, like the beautiful Black Panther Party, whose 50-year anniversary will be coming up in 2016. So you have to keep a lookout for Oakland, California, as well as the legacy of the Black Panther Party, giving all power to the people, because we are powerful. Actually, all beings are powerful. We would not be here if we weren't powerful. We would not have what we would not have today if we are not powerful. And so to display that and give that back is what we are sitting here doing. And that That is what Art and Soul is about. That is what Joyce Gordon's Gallery in the heart of downtown Oakland is about. That's what this block on 14th Street in between Franklin and Broadway is about. Establishing that black Mecca, establishing that black love, establishing that rapport of just giving back to the people, but not sitting here saying that, oh, we're only going to do business in this way. We're building that rapport with all people. We want to show the world that the negativity that they're seeing on the media, you know, the stigmas, that is not what this is about, that we have some beautiful art pieces here. And so if you get a chance, well, Art and Soul is over, but the gallery is always open. She's here Monday through Sunday. If there's no event, she might not be here on Sunday, but there is always something going on in here in downtown Oakland. And so don't forget about the Black Panther Party and their 50-year anniversary coming up, as well as all the history, all the givings, anything that has been birthed from the Bay Area. It has come from Oakland. Even Occupy Oakland was a big hit. I met so many people from all over the world when Occupy Oakland popped off, because everyone wanted to get a piece of that Oakland revolutionary, that Oakland love, that Oakland drive to say, no, we're not going to take this anymore. No, we're not going to sit here and be controlled. We have a voice. We are the people. And I am because we are. And that is what this comes down to. So once again, this is I Am Andy, the cultural entrepreneur. I can be found on Facebook, Andy, A-N-D-I, Africa, A-F-R-I-K. Andy is analyzing the Negro's disparity intellectually. Give thanks. Peace.